In this lecture, we see the types of semiconductors. We know that the resistivity of a semiconductor is less than an insulator but more than a conductor. And we also know that semiconductors have negative temperature coefficient of resistance. That is, the resistance of a semiconductor decreases with increase in temperature and vice versa. That is, when we increase the temperature of a semiconductor, its resistance is going to decrease because more electrons and hole pairs can be generated due to increase in the temperature, that result in the increase in the available energy for the electron hole pairs. So due to increase in the conduction electrons, their conductivity is also going to increase, and hence their resistance is going to decrease. But when we see in case of metals, as we increase the temperature, their resistance is going to also increase, which is due to an increase in the scattering in metals. That is, as we increase the temperature of a metal, their amplitude of their atomic vibrations is also going to increase, and due to this increase in atomic vibrations, there are more scattering of electrons in the metals, and in this way we can get an increase in the resistance. So this is the main difference between a metal and a semiconductor, and you can get this type of question in any interview, I mean in PhD interview or in your practical viva. So this is very important point to note. Now let's see how many types of semiconductors we can have in nature or in our laboratory or in our day-to-day life. So we can classify semiconductors mainly into four categories. That is, first is based on their elemental composition, second one is based on their doping, third one is based on their nature of charge carriers, and fourth one is based on their nature of band gap. And we have already studied about the band gaps in semiconductors. Semiconductors can have a direct or a indirect band gap. So first let me see the semiconductors based on their composition or their elemental composition. So according to their composition, semiconductors can be of two types, that is elemental semiconductor and second one is compound semiconductors. So We know that in elemental semiconductors, all the constituent atoms are of the same kind. That is, for example, silicon and germanium are elemental semiconductors, because here all the constituent atoms are made of single element, that is here silicon and here germanium. But in compound semiconductors, these type of semiconductors is composed of atoms of two or more different elements. That is, for example, gallium arsenide, gallium nitride, zinc sulfide. So all these are compound semiconductors, and we know that most of the elemental semiconductors like silicon and germanium are having covalent bonding. That is, these semiconductors have covalent bonding. But most of the compound semiconductors have covalent plus ionic bonding, and most of the compound semiconductors made by third and fifth groups are wider band gap semiconductors, because in these semiconductors we can have covalent bond, and at the same time we can have some percentage of ionic bond, because just like gallium and arsenic, due to difference in their electronegativity, we can have a positive and a negative charge on both of these elements. So due to the presence of this ionic bond in this third and fifth group semiconductors, their band gap is larger than the band gap of these elemental semiconductors. And we also know that most of the elemental semiconductors are having indirect band gap, but most of the compound semiconductors are having direct band gap. So this classification is based on their elemental composition. That is, semiconductors can be of elemental semiconductor, and they can also be compound semiconductors. In elemental semiconductors, we mostly use these two semiconductors, that is silicon and germanium. But in case of compound semiconductors, there are many types of compound semiconductors. That is, we can have compound semiconductors based on this third and fifth group. We can also have compound semiconductors that are based on second and sixth group. Sometimes we can also have semiconductors based on this combination of fourth and fourth group. And we know that most of the elemental semiconductors are belong to this fourth group of the periodic table. So just like here we can have silicon carbide compound semiconductor that is made by silicon and carbon, and both of these elements are present in this fourth group. So we can have many compound semiconductors, and most of the LEDs we can, or LCD, we can see these compound semiconductors. So our second classification is based on their doping. डोपिंग। वी ऑल नो दैट वी कैन हैव ए प्योर सेमीकंडक्टर, एंड वी नो दैट द कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ ए प्योर सेमीकंडक्टर इज वेरी लो, सो टू इंक्रीज इट्स कंडक्टिविटी वी हैव टू एड सम इम्प्यूरिटी। सो वी कैन क्लासिफाई सेमीकंडक्टर्स बेस्ड ऑन दिस डोपिंग, दैट इज प्योर सेमीकंडक्टर और इंट्रिंसिक सेमीकंडक्टर। एंड सेकेंड वन इज वी कैन ऑल्सो कॉल इट एज अनडोप्ड, एंड सेकेंड वन इज डोप्ड और एक्सट्रिंसिक सेमीकंडक्टर। सो वी कैन क्लासिफाई सेमीकंडक्टर्स इनटू टू कैटेगरीज, दैट इज प्योर सेमीकंडक्टर और अनडोप्ड सेमीकंडक्टर और इंट्रिंसिक और इंट्रिंसिक सेमीकंडक्टर, एंड सेकंड वन इज डोप्ड सेमीकंडक्टर्स, एक्सट्रिंसिक सेमीकंडक्टर्स एक्सेट्रा। सो दिस इज सेकंड कैटेगरी ऑफ द सेमीकंडक्टर्स। एंड थर्ड वन इज बेस्ड ऑन देयर चार्ज कैरियर्स, दैट इज इफ द कंडक्टिविटी इन ए सेमीकंडक्टर इज ड्यू टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, देन वी कैन कॉल इट एज ए एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर। एंड इफ द कंडक्टिविटी इन ए सेमीकंडक्टर इज ड्यू टू होल्स, देन वी कैन कॉल इट एज ए पी टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर। सो वी कैन क्लासिफाई सेमीकंडक्टर्स इनटू टू कैटेगरीज बेस्ड ऑन देयर नेचर ऑफ चार्ज कैरियर्स, दैट इज एन टाइप और पी टाइप। आई एम श्योर यू ऑल नो अबाउट दिस क्लासिफिकेशन। एंड फोर्थ वन इज बेस्ड ऑन देयर बैंड गैप, दैट इज नेचर ऑफ बैंड गैप। दैट इज सेमीकंडक्टर्स कैन बी क्लासिफाइड एज डायरेक्ट बैंड गैप सेमीकंडक्टर, एंड द सेकंड वन इज इनडायरेक्ट बैंड गैप सेमीकंडक्टर। फॉर एग्जांपल सिलिकॉन एंड जर्मेनियम आर हैविंग डायरेक्ट बैंड गैप, बट कंपाउंड सेमीकंडक्टर्स लाइक गैलियम आर्सेनाइड, गैलियम नाइट्राइड, दीज सेमीकंडक्टर्स आर हैविंग दीज कंपाउंड सेमीकंडक्टर्स आर हैविंग कंपाउंड सेमीकंडक्टर्स आर हैविंग डायरेक्ट बैंड गैप, दैट इज गैलियम एंड आर्सेनाइड, गैलियम नाइट्राइड। These compound semiconductors are having direct band gap, but elemental semiconductors like silicon and germanium, these semiconductors are having indirect band gap. That's why we can't use silicon or germanium for making of LEDs. that is light emitting diodes. Most of the LEDs we see in our daily life are made by gallium arsenide, and by adding some extra impurity we can tune the band gap of this gallium arsenide. And this is the beauty of these compound semiconductors, that we can easily tune their band gaps. But for elemental semiconductors like silicon and germanium, it's not very easy to alter their band gap. But for compound semiconductors, we can easily tune their band gap. That is, we can make a green LED with this gallium and arsenic, and by adding some more impurity we can have a LEDs with red color made by this gallium and arsenic. So here meaning is that we can easily tune their band gap. So for classification of semiconductors, there are many other ways by which we can classify or we can distribute semiconductors. Just like semiconductors can be amorphous or crystalline in nature, semiconductors can be divided into single crystal or in polycrystal, and we can also distribute semiconductors according to their conductivity or their current carriers. That is, some semiconductors can be classified as ionic semiconductors and other can be classified as electronic semiconductors. In ionic semiconductors, current can be carried by ions, and in electronic semiconductors, current can be carried by the electrons. So there are many ways by which we can differentiate these semiconductors, but these four categories are very important. And among these four categories, first two categories are very important, because in third semester we can study the properties of these compound semiconductors, and we have to differentiate the properties of elemental semiconductors and compound semiconductors. And it's very easy to know the classification of semiconductors according to their doping, that is intrinsic or extrinsic semiconductors. So in many interviews you can get this type of question, that is, how can we differentiate semiconductors or how can we classify semiconductors. So this lecture is very important. It's very simple, but sometime we can get confused. That is, when we in a simple interview, when you divide semiconductors into intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors, then you can get other question, that is, tell me some more about this classification. Then you can tell that we can also classify or we can also divide semiconductors based on their elemental composition, that is, elemental semiconductors and compound semiconductors.